बीएससी वन सेमेस्टर वन स्ट्रक्चरल जियोलॉजी. इन द लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव इंट्रोड्यूस्ड विथ स्ट्रक्चरल जियोलॉजी, इट्स डेफिनेशन, प्लेनर स्ट्रक्चर्स, लिनियर स्ट्रक्चर्स एंड टोपोग्राफी. इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न डिफरेंट इम्पोर्टेंट टर्मिनोलॉजी और डिफरेंट टर्म्स इन स्ट्रक्चरल जियोलॉजी. दीज आर सम बेसिक कंसेप्ट्स इन स्ट्रक्चरल जियोलॉजी विदाउट विच फर्दर स्टडी ऑफ स्ट्रक्चरल जियोलॉजी इज नॉट पॉसिबल. सो दीज टर्म्स आर वेरी वेरी इम्पोर्टेंट एंड दीज आर बेसिक टर्म्स और फाउंडेशन ऑफ स्ट्रक्चरल जियोलॉजी. इफ वन वॉन्ट्स टू स्टडी स्ट्रक्चरल जियोलॉजी इन डिटेल, द पर्सन मस्ट नो दीज बेसिक टर्म्स. सो द फर्स्ट टर्म इज बेड्स और स्ट्रेटिफिकेशन. अ बेड और लेयर और स्ट्रेटा इज द फर्स्ट टर्म इन स्ट्रक्चरल जियोलॉजी. इट इज नथिंग बट द प्लेनर अरेंजमेंट ऑफ मिनरल्स. प्लेनर अरेंजमेंट मीन्स द मिनरल्स आर अरेंज्ड इन टू लेयर्स और बेड्स वन आफ्टर अनदर. वन मिनरल गेट्स डिपॉजिटेड इन द फॉर्म ऑफ लेयर, देन द सेकेंड लेयर गेट्स डिपॉजिटेड आफ्टर इट, देन कम्स थर्ड लेयर एंड सो ऑन. इट इज अ कैरेक्टरिस्टिक फीचर ऑफ सेडिमेंटरी रॉक्स. दिस बेडिंग और स्ट्रेटिफिकेशन एस्पेशली फाउंड इन सेडिमेंटरी रॉक्स. हाउएवर सम इग्नियस एंड मेटामॉर्फिक रॉक्स ऑल्सो शो सुडो स्ट्रेटिफिकेशन. सुडो स्ट्रेटिफिकेशन मीन्स दे आर नॉट बेड्स और दे डू नॉट शो बेडिंग स्ट्रक्चर इन रियल सेंस, बट इट रिजेंबल्स टू बेडिंग और स्ट्रेटिफिकेशन इन सेडिमेंटरी रॉक. हेंस इट इज कॉल्ड एज सुडो स्ट्रेटिफिकेशन. द टू एडजेसेंट बेड्स मे शो डिफरेंस इन कलर, टेक्सचर एंड कंपोजिशन. दो द बेड्स आर फॉर्म्ड ऑफ सेम मिनरल, इवन देन दे डिफर इन कलर. वन बेड मे बी ऑफ डार्क कलर, अनदर मे बी समवॉट lighter in color. Their texture means whether they are fine grain or coarse grain. This texture is also different and their composition. Sometimes the beds are made up of same mineral, sometimes they are made up of different minerals, means their composition is different. And the boundary between two adjacent beds is called as bedding plane, means the boundary which separates two successive or adjacent beds is called as bedding plane. Thus beds are made up of minerals, they differ in their color, texture and composition, and these are characteristic features of sedimentary rocks. However, in some igneous and metamorphic rocks also bedding is found. This is diagram of bedding structure. Here we can observe the bedding planes, that is the dark lines which separates two adjacent beds. Also we can observe here the difference in color, texture and composition as we have said earlier. Next term, very very important and very very basic term in structural geology is strike. What is strike? Once we approach or goes for studying a particular bed, if that bed is inclined, incline means it is making some angle with horizontal plane. If the bed is horizontal, then there is no question of dip and strike. But when the bed is not horizontal, it is inclined, that is it makes some angle with horizontal plane, then in that case we have to determine its attitude. Attitude means its dip and strike. So what is strike? It is a direction. Strike is nothing but a direction of bed. And it can be defined as a line obtained by intersection of the bedding with the horizontal plane. Making some angle means that the beds are inclined and they get intersect with the horizontal plane. And due to this intersection, a certain line forms. This line is called as strike of that particular bed. And as it is a direction, it is always given with reference to geographical north. When we are talking about strike of a particular bed, that is, we are talking about its extension, that is the direction in which the bed has been deposited. When we say that the strike is north south, it means that the bed deposited in the direction north south. Starting from north, the beds are extended in the south, or sometimes it may be northeast southwest, but always we give this direction with reference to geographical north. Another feature of strike is that it is always at right angle to the true depth. It means that it is always perpendicular to the true depth of that particular bed. And it is independent of the amount of depth. Though strike and depth are associated with each other, there is no direct connection between depth and strike. Means strike is independent of the amount of depth. Here it is shown that strike line is nothing but the direction of these beds. Here inclined strata is shown, deep angle is also shown. It is inclined by 18 degrees with respect to horizontal plane. And here we can see that deep and strike are perpendicular to each other, and by the help of strike line, the strike direction is shown in this diagram. Next term is depth. As the strike is direction, the depth is expressed in both terms, that it is an angle and also a direction. The definition is, it is an angle formed by intersection of the bed and the horizontal surface. When the beds and the horizontal surface get intersected, a line formed is called a strike. But due to that intersection, an angle gets formed. That angle is nothing but depth of that particular bed. It is measured in vertical plane and expressed in degrees. As it is an angle, it is always expressed in degrees. True depth is always perpendicular to the strike of the bed. Means it is in 90 degrees of the strike of the bed. And deep angle, when we measure deep angle in any other direction, that is except 90 degree, that deep is called as apparent deep. And deep angle varies from 0 to 90 degree. When it is 90 degree, it is called as true deep. When it ranges between 0 to 89 degrees or 1 to 89 degrees, it is called as apparent deep. True depth, the definition is, it is the maximum inclination of the bedding plane with the horizontal plane. The maximum inclination means it is 90 degree angle. It is not more than that. Maximum angle is 90 degree and it is called as true depth. It is expressed in terms of degree of inclination and the direction in which beds are inclined. Next is apparent depth. The depth in any other direction other than true depth is apparent depth. As it is different from true depth, it is always less than 90 degree. The maximum angle is 90 degree, it is called as true depth, and any angle lesser than 90 degree is called as apparent depth. This is a diagrammatic representation of depth. Here we can see that strike and depth are perpendicular to each other. The depth perpendicular to strike is 90 degree. It is called as true depth. एंड हियर एट द साइड ऑफ द डायग्राम अगेन अ डीप एंगल हैज बीन शोन. इट इज कॉल्ड एज एपरेंट डिप. इट इज लेसर देन 90 डिग्री. नेक्स्ट इंपॉर्टेंट टर्म इज कंटूर और कंटूर्स. मोटर कंटूर्स इन द मैप, जियोलॉजिकल मैप और टोपोग्राफिकल मैप, कंटूर्स आर शोन बाय डॉटेड लाइन्स. बट वॉट आर कंटूर्स? दीज आर एन इमेजिनरी लाइन्स जॉइनिंग पॉइंट्स ऑफ इक्वल हाइट. व्हेन वी गो टू फील्ड, फील्ड मीन्स आउटसाइड एरिया, टू ऑब्जर्व अ पर्टिकुलर जियोलॉजिकल फीचर, एट दैट टाइम वी डिनोट इट्स हाइट विद द हेल्प ऑफ कंटूर्स. बट इन द एक्चुअल फील्ड देर आर नो सच लाइन्स प्रेजेंट. वी जस्ट इमेजिन दैट सच लाइन्स आर प्रेजेंट देयर एंड सच लाइन्स आर दोज लाइन्स विच जॉइंस पॉइंट ऑफ इक्वल हाइट, मीन्स टू पॉइंट्स ऑफ 100 meters. इफ वी इमेजिनरी इमेजिन दैट वी आर जॉइनिंग दिस टू पॉइंट्स, वी फॉर्म वन कंटूर ऑफ 100 meters. इफ वी गो अपवर्ड एट द हाइट ऑफ 200 meters एंड अगेन वी इमेजिन दैट देर आर टू पॉइंट्स ऑन टू अपोजिट साइड्स हैविंग एलिवेशन 200 meters, एंड इफ वी कंसिडर दैट वी आर जॉइनिंग दिस टू पॉइंट्स ऑफ 200 meters, वी फॉर्म अनदर कंटूर ऑफ 200 meters एंड सो ऑन. द कंटूर्स आर ऑफ टू टाइप्स, स्ट्रक्चरल कंटूर्स एंड टोपोग्राफिक कंटूर्स. नेक्स्ट इज द वर्टिकल डिस्टेंस बिटवीन टू सक्सेसिव कंटूर्स इज कॉल्ड एज कंटूर इंटरवल. एज वी हैव सीन इन द एग्जाम्पल, वन कंटूर लाइन इज ड्रॉन फॉर 100 meters, अनदर कंटूर लाइन इज ड्रॉन फॉर 200 meters, द डिफरेंस इज 100 meter. दिस 100 meter इज द कंटूर इंटरवल. दिस इंटरवल मे वेरी इन डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ मैप्स. इट मे बी 10 meters, 20 meters और 50 meters. कंटूर्स आर यूज टू डिनोट एलिवेशन अबव मीन सी लेवल. इट यूज टू डिनोट द हाइट और एलिवेशन ऑफ द पर्टिक्युलर एरिया और पर्टिक्युलर फीचर फ्रॉम द मीन सी लेवल. म्हणजे समुद्र सपाटीपासूनची एखाद्या ठिकाणाची उंची ही कशामुळे दाखवली जाते किंवा कशाने दाखवली जाते, कशाच्या साह्याने? तर कंटूर्सच्या. दीज आर द कंटूर लाइन्स. ऑलवेज रिमेंबर दॅट दीज आर इमॅजिनरी लाईन्स. व्हेन वी गो इन द फील्ड वी डू नॉट ऑब्झर्व सच लाईन्स ॲक्च्युली इन द फील्ड. वी जस्ट इमॅजिन फॉर द पर्पज ऑफ अंडरस्टँडिंग. हेअर वी कॅन सी 40, 60, 80, 100, 120 and 140 meters. It means that contour interval is 20 meters. And two opposite points are joined by a line which is called as contour line or simply a contour. Again, slope has been shown, concave slope and convex slope. Again, contours are there which joins the points of opposite side. Next term is outcrop. Outcrop is the exposure of the rock. Our earth is made up of rocks, whether it may be igneous, in Marathi we call it as Agnijanya Khadak, or sedimentary, in Marathi Starit Khadak, or metamorphic, in Marathi we call it as Rupantarit Khadak. However, these solid rocks are not exposed everywhere. It lies behind the soil cover. But at certain places, the rock gets exposed on the surface, and in that case, it is called as outcrop or rock outcrop. It is formed due to weathering and erosion or tectonic movements. The uppermost soil cover which covers the rock, it gets eroded due to weathering or erosion or due to tectonic disturbances, and the rock gets exposed on the surface. Outcrop is extremely useful for understanding geological history, to study depositional features, structural features like folds, foliations, etc. when we are talking about structural geology and we are going to study further different structural features like folds, faults, joints, unconformities, all these features are formed in the rock. They do not form elsewhere. We must study the rock to study these structural features. Hence, rock outcrop is very, very important. If rock is not exposed on the surface, we are not able to study these different structural features. Hence, it is extremely useful for understanding geological history, means what happened in the geological past, what disturbances has been taken place, how the rock has been reacted to that different forces or disturbances, and as a result, what are the different structural features formed in the rock. All this study is possible only with the help of outcrop. Also, some rocks, especially sedimentary rocks, contains fossils. Fossil means remains of dead organisms, which may be plants or animal remains. So, outcrop is also important for studying fossil content and paleo. Paleo means ancient environment. What were the ancient environmental conditions or atmospheric conditions in that particular area? This can be studied with the help of outcrop. Outcrops may be of different size and shape. They may be horizontal or may be inclined. Generally, horizontal beds make horizontal outcrops on the ground, irrespective of the gradient and irregularities of the land surface. It means that even though the land surface is uneven or full of irregularities, or it may have slope, even then, if the rock beds are horizontal, the outcrop will be horizontal. Also, because topographic contour lines are horizontal, the outcrops of the horizontal units always parallel to the topographic contours. As we have seen earlier, there are two types of contours, topographic contours and structural contours. The outcrops of horizontal rocks are parallel to topographic contours. In this lecture, we have seen different important terms. First is bedding, then strike, dip, contours, and last outcrop. Please go through this presentation carefully. It is very, very important for further study of structural geology. This is the diagrammatic representation of outcrop. Any rock exposure, when we go outside, we see that rocks are lying in different manner. That is nothing but rock outcrop.